Hi guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome if you are here for the first time. Today we have another fancy stationery review and Factor Notes was yet again very kind enough to send me their latest planner, which is the Planner 2021. They have a range of almost 5 to 6 different planner covers, planners which have come out with different designs. Of course, the inside of all of them remains the same, so we are going to be unboxing. Even I haven't seen it yet. I am so excited to unbox this. I really, really am excited. And so yeah, this is going to be like a first view, and I'm just going to take you through the unboxing, show you how the planner looks like, and then later on we will again, of course, come back with my proper final review of the planner after I've started using it. But for today, let's just unbox this. I can't wait. And oh yeah, Merry Christmas to all of you out there. So without talking much, let's just get started. So they've sent me the calendar, which I totally wasn't expecting. Okay, they just told me they're going to be sending me the planner, and they sent a planner calendar too. So this is their 2021 Factor Notes calendar. The planner, So the calendar comes with this very minimalist flower design, floral print on the top, and then you have the months over here. Under each month, they've put different words like hope, and then you have dream, and then you have wish, and so on and so forth it goes. And it's a dual-sided calendar, so you have 1 month here, and then when you reach the end, then you come back over here with December. So that's how the calendar looks like. It's very minimal, it's very chic, it'll look amazing on your desks. So I like this. And now moving on to the main star of the show, which is the planner. Oh my god, it is so cute. And they sent me the doggo one. This is how it looks like. So yeah, it's a doggo one. Okay, I just love the planner design. So firstly, speaking about the features of the planner, they say this has yearly, monthly view, weekly overviews, you have the daily planning sections, you have ways to track your habits, goals, vision, set reminders, motivational quotes, monthly exercises for exploration. Ooh, I'm excited to try this one out. Letter prompts for yourself, monthly budget planning, track your progress, puzzles, riddles, brain teasers, cute stickers. There are so many things, so let's just open and get seen what it is. So yeah. It opens up to this page where you write your name and all of those things. And first of all, before we go ahead, I want to tell you that the quality of the paper is really amazing. I don't think, okay, so they haven't mentioned GSM of the paper anywhere over here. But the paper, the stationery that they sent me last time had around 100 to 120 GSM of the sheets. So these look pretty good quality too. And then you have your thumbnail. So you can either draw yourself out here, you can put your fingerprint or whatever you want. Okay. And then you have the top 5 goals of the year page, which is good because frankly speaking, more than 5 and then the year is too less. You have like really huge and important goals. So I think 5 is the max, and it's really, it makes sense having 5 goals a year. Next you have your vision board and you have your mind map. So I think I might change my mind map to, or this, you can change these pages. I might mainly change it to my section where I put the Polaroids and show how my year 2021 was looking like. Or you can just leave it that way if you have like a vision board and mind map, which is again good pages to have. Oh, then you have a nice section for my favorite quotes out here. And you can write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 quotes over here. So if you are a reader, or if you're a writer, or if you just randomly listen to some good quotes somewhere, you can put them down here, and at the end of the, you can just like, you know, flip back and see what all you found. Next you have days to remember, which is a good addition. You know, like usually you can just put it on every monthly views, but I think this is a good thing too because you just get the list over here on one page. You can put your birthdays, anniversaries, any other important dates, your date nights, and all of those things on this page. So which is again a good thing. This is a very rare page to see on other planners, but Factor Notes, you've done it right by having it out here. Then you have your improvement plan for mind, body, work, relationships. So how you want to improve each of these sections, it shows you all of that out here. And there's enough space for you to write it. Like, I mean, you're not going to change everything in 1 year, but so this much is going to be enough for you. And oh, they have this cute letter to myself. It says you're about to begin a new year, a year of progress and happiness. And so you can just write a letter to yourself out here. I have seen this kind of a letter to myself page in the Alisha Souza planner too. So, and I don't think I have seen it elsewhere. I'm not sure. I may be wrong. But factor notes, really good thing to have included this out here. So you can write a letter to yourself on the start. You can write it in this month. You can write it in the 1st of Jan. And just seal it and put it away. They have a pouch too over here at the end. So you can just save it in this pouch and come back to it, read it in the end of 2021 or even in 10 years or 15 years, whenever you want. But that's what it says, okay? And then you have your I, Me, Myself page where you write a lot of things about yourself. You can see there are a lot of insightful questions out here which you can fill up and write for yourself. So it has a lot of things about yourself that you can really dive into and fill it. It says ask about your passions, your hobbies, what things you're proud of, your habits that you want to cultivate, things that make you hangry, things that make you happy, biggest life lessons that you've learned till now, I want $1 million, what you would do, stop worrying about. So there's a lot of things that you can actually dive into and fill up and then come back to it and read it whenever you want. Next, I like the meal plan. So this is how the meal plan looks like. You have one day of each day of the week, and there are different blocks and you can fill it up for your breakfast, lunch, snacks and dinner. Good that the snacks part is included too out here. And then you have your ideal day in 2021. So you have your activity, you have your mornings and your evenings, how you want to plan them, and everything is written down here. Next, you have your ideal week. Okay, so this is something that I have read about in a lot of productivity sites where they give you this kind of pages, okay, and they say that if you divide your day, into every hour of the day, and then you put down your activities out there and you allot each section, say for you have 5 a.m. it starts at 5 a.m. so say you want to work out, you say 5 to 7 is going to be your workout, so you can fill in your workout times over here. You can fill out each and every slot, how much time you want to spend on watching TV, on working, on cultivating your hobbies, meditating, reading. You can put all of that out here, so that is amazing too. And finally, you have the yearly overview where you have the entire year 2021 calendar out here, and then the next page is for your notes. And then there is like so many things right at the start, and then finally you come to January, which is like your monthlies, and you have cute illustrations on each page. So this is for my Jan, and you have a fair much. I don't want to open everything because I like opening my planners and seeing it as a surprise as to what inside looks. I'm just going to show you Jan. So it says hello January, so the adventure begins. And then you have your normal monthly view where again you can put your special events or just like a monthly view when you want a glance of whatever like is your monthly activities. You can put that out here, and they have included this tiny note section out here, which is again very really really useful. Because like a monthly view, I can just write down here, like if there's someone's birthday, I can just directly put gift, like get the gift for so and so and so on. Then you have a budget plan where you have your income, you have your planned and you have your actual. Next, you have your EMIs, payments, expenses, like your EMIs, monthly bills, your electricity bills, your shopping sprees, everything goes under this section. Again, over there, you have your planned and actual section. This is very useful actually. I have not seen this planned and actual wala thing also in other planners, so ye bahut acha hai. This is also really good. I'm glad that they included that kind of a bifurcation. And next, you have your shopping list for the month. Of course, if you need to buy your groceries, your gifts, or anything for yourself, all of that comes under there. Oh, and then they have this doodle your feelings. They say you're about to start planning a new year and it must be exciting. Here's a little space to doodle out what you are feeling and joy. So they have this doodle page over here where you can like just doodle your thoughts or just do all random doodles. And if you don't doodle, frankly, you can just scribble your way into it and do whatever you want, because this is your space and just whatever makes you happy, do it. You don't have to like be an artist to fill this section, but it's an amazing section to have. And then you have your normal dailies. You have your daily section where you write your daily to-do list. Or if you're using this as a, not a lot of people use planners as planners, a lot of people use them as journals. So you can write your daily thoughts and your daily feelings, all of that in over here too. So this is a pro tip. So if you are not into planning and you still want to buy planners, because there are cute planners everywhere, and just look at this one, isn't it so cute? Who wouldn't want this on their desk? And they have many more pretty designs, okay, so go check out the other designs. So you cannot, it's not necessary that you just plan, you can even write your thoughts into it. So I have made another video on how important journaling is and how it is very important to write and journal, to, you know, like a source, put down your thoughts on paper or wherever you want. So this, you go check out that video too, I'll link it up somewhere, and this planner can be useful for that as well. So moving on, next you have things to remember, you have the habit tracker, and you have other things like the top priorities of the week. Okay, I believe this is the weekly priorities. Yes, so this is your weekly priorities. They have like the weekly priorities piche too, and then there are other two columns. You can use it the way you want. Frankly, I could put like my, if I have some major appointments or calls. I'm planning to use this for my office work mostly, so I can see a lot of use for those sections. And then you have your tiny notes out here too. Another good thing that they have is they have given this cute section pouch here where you can put in your sticky notes, your letters, your other stickers, and they come with cute stickers too. Oh my god, too much excitement and too many stickers. Like, I can't believe there's this sticker, then there is this sticker, and there is this one, and then there's this one. There are so many stickers, they're like cute words, and it's just perfect. Okay, so I love the planner overall, and so far so good. I like the planner, I like the quality, I love the amount of space that they've given for everything in here. They've taken care of really tiny elements, and they've given three bookmarks, okay, like three. Like, I'm always, otherwise, like, I need one on my monthly view, I need one on my current week, and then I need one for my meal plans. So this is amazing, and kudos, Factor Notes, you have done an amazing job. So this planner retails at ₹2199, as I said, but right now you can find it for ₹999 on their website. Yes, they have their website too. I'll include a link to their website in the description box, and I'll even include a link to this particular planner if you want in the description box, and you can go and check out. They have a lot of designs, and I love the way they have made it. It's very thoughtful, and for a person like me who loves planners, who loves planning, who loves journaling, this one has everything in it, literally. So if you are somebody who is looking for one overall planner, and like, you know, you just want one place to go, you don't want to have a separate wellness tracker, you don't want to have a different journal, you don't want to have a separate planning planner, so this can be your one. So go check it out, go buy it, and if you do, don't forget to tag me on your photos on Instagram. I love to see them. So that's all for today. We will be back soon with a review video once I'm like done with it, maybe like a 2-monthly or 3-monthly review on this planner, and I can't wait for all of you to see that. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please go and subscribe. Yes, that's it. Don't forget to like, share, and comment on the video. Merry Christmas, all of you, and a Happy New Year to all of you. And yes, we're gonna be back soon with a lot. Until then, toodles.